Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My name is Dr. Tariq Abbas, Associate Professor of Electrical Engineering Department of Sarhad University of Science and Information Technology, Peshawar. The subject name, Biostatistics. Today, discuss the lecture number one, the Meyer of Central Tendency, in which we discuss arithmetic mean and harmonic mean. Meyer of Central Tendency and arithmetic definition. In general terms, central tendency is a statistical measure that determines a single value that accurately describes the center of the distribution and represents the entire distribution of scores. In other words, the goal of central tendency is to identify the single value that is the best representative for the entire set of data. There are five averages, among them mean, median, and mode are called simple averages, and the other two averages, geometric mean and harmonic mean, are called the special averages. Arithmetic mean or mean. Arithmetic mean are simply the mean of a variable is defined as the sum of the observation divided by the number of observations. If the variable x assumes n values, x1, x2, x3, up to xn, then the mean x bar is given by x bar is equal to x1 plus x2 plus x3 up to so on plus xn divided by n. In other words, x bar is equal to summation I is equal to 1 up to n xn divided by n. This formula for ungroup or raw data. Question: calculate the mean for 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So there are five values are given, so taking the sum of these values and divide by the total number of observation, we get the average value. So this average value is represent the whole of the data. This is known as the Meyer of Central Tendency. So solution of the problem, x bar 2 plus 4 plus 6 plus 8 plus 10 divided by 5 is equal to 30 divided by 5 is equal to 6. So 6 is the average value which represent the as a whole entire data. So this single value represent the Meyer of Central Tendency. Group data. The mean for group data is obtained from the following formula. X bar is equal to summation fx divided by n. The capital N means summation f, the sum of the frequencies, where x is the midpoint of the individual class, f is the frequency of the individual class, and n is the sum of the frequencies or total frequencies. So this is the numerical problem in which the student more about learn about the arithmetic mean from the following group data. This is known as the frequency distribution. Find the arithmetic mean of the following frequency distribution, x is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. F is the frequency 5, 9, 12, 17, 14, 10, and 6. So solution of the problem, write the column x in the downward 1 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is shown the marks of the student in the biostatistics subject. So number of student 5 which gets 1 mark, 9 student which gets 2 marks, every student get 2 marks, 12 student in which every student got 3 marks, 17 student in which every student got 4 marks, and 14 student in which every student got 5 marks, 10 student got 6 marks, 6 student 7. So according to the formula, taking the product of the marks and the frequency column, so we will get fx, 5 ones are 5, 9 twos are 18, 12 threes are 36, 17 fours are 68, 14 fives are 70, 10 sixes are 60, 6 sevens are 42. So taking the sum of the f frequency column and taking the sum of the fx column, so the sum of the frequency column is 72. It means capital N is summation f. Fx summation fx is known from 5 plus 18 plus 36 plus 68 plus 70 plus 60 plus 42 is equal to 299. So this column sum fx divided by the summation f, it means x bar summation fx divided by n. The capital N means the sum of the frequency column, all the frequencies. So 299 divided by 72, we will get 4.09 or round of figure 4.1. This is the average marks per student. This is the continuous data. Calculate the arithmetic mean of the marks from the following table. Marks from 0 to 10 group, from 10 to 20, from 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50, and 50 to 60. So the number of student 12 which got the mark from 0 to 10 in this group, 18 student which got the marks lie in between 10 and 20, and 27 student got marks in lie in between 20 and 30 group, and 20 student got marks between 30 and 40, 17 student got the marks between 40 to 50, and 6 student got marks 50 to 60. So solution of the problem: the first column is the marks from 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and 50 to 60. Number of students, it means the frequency 12, 18, 27, 20, 17, 6, and 100. This sum is 100. So taking the midpoint, midpoint is known as the average of the class in which the upper limit and lower limit are added to each other and divide by 2, we get the average of this class is known as the midpoint. So 0 plus 10 divided by 2 is 5, 10 plus 20 divided by 2, 30 divided by 2, 15, 30 plus 20 divided by 2, 50 divided by 2, 25, 40 plus 70 divided by 2 is 35, 50 plus 40 is 90, 90 divided by 2, 45, 60 plus 50 is 110 divided by 2 is 55. So we get a new column which is known as the midpoint. So this midpoint column is multiplied with the frequency column. For 5, we will get fx, 12 5s are 60, 18 15s are 270, 17 multiplied by 25 675, 20 multiplied by 35 is 700, 17 multiplied by 45 765, 6 multiplied by 55, so we'll get 330. Taking the sum of the f column means 12 plus 18 plus 27 plus 20 plus 17 plus 6 is 100. So taking the sum of the column of fx, 60 plus 270, 675, 700, 765, 330, will get 2800. So x bar is equal to summation fx divided by summation f. So 2800 divided by 100, we will get 28. This is the average. This is shows the entire, these whole data, represent the whole data. It means a single value. It is known as the central tendency. So 28 means the average marks per student. Merits. It is rigidly defined. It is easy to understand and easy to calculate. If the number of items is sufficiently large, it is more accurate and more reliable. It is calculated value and is not based on its position in the series. Fifth, if it is possible to calculate even if some of the details of the data are lacking, of all averages, it is affected least by the fluctuation of sampling. It provides a good basis for comparison. Demerit, it cannot be obtained by inspection or not located through a frequency graph. It cannot be in the study of the qualitative phenomena, not capable of numerical measurement, that is intelligence, beauty, honesty, etc. It can ignore any single item only at the risk of losing its accuracy. It is affected very much by the extreme values. It cannot be calculated for open-end classes. It may be lead to fallacious conclusion if the detail of the data from which it is computed are not given. Harmonic mean. Harmonic mean of the set of the observation is defined as the reciprocal of the arithmetic average of the reciprocal of the given values if x1, x2, x3 up to xn are n observations. Harmonic mean is means total number of observations divided by summation I is equal to 1 up to n and taking the reciprocal 1 over xi for the frequency distribution. Harmonic mean summation f divided by summation I is equal to 1 up to n f into 1 over xi. Merits, it is rigidly defined. It is defined on all observation. It is amenable to further algebraic treatment. It is the most suitable less average when it is desired to give a greater weight of smaller observation and weight to the larger ones. Demerits of the harmonic mean. It is not easily understood. It is difficult to compute. It is only a summary figure and may not be the actual item in the series. It gives the greater importance to small items and is therefore useful only when small items have to be given greater weightage. From the given data, calculate the harmonic mean 5, 10, 17, 24, and 30. So solution of the problem, write in the x column, this is known as the 5, 10, 17, 24, and 30. This is the x column, and taking the reciprocal of the x column. So 1 over x means 1 by 5, it means 0.20. 1 by 10 is 0.100. 1 divided by 17, 0.0588. 1 divided by 24, we get 0.0417. 1 divided by 30, 0.0333. Taking the sum of the column of 1 over x, so 0.20 plus 0.10, 0.0588, 0.0417, 0.033, 0.4338. So harmonic mean n is equal to summation I is equal to 1 up to n 1 xi. So total number of observation is 5. 5 divided by the 1 over x column sum 0.4338. We will get 11.526. Question: the marks secured by some student of a class are given below. Calculate the harmonic mean. Marks 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. Number of students 427131. So the first column is shows the marks of the student 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, and 25. So the number of students denote the frequency column. So 4, 2, 7, 1, 3, 1. Its sum is 18. So taking the reciprocal of the first column, 1 by x 1 by 20 0.0576 1 by 22 0.0454 1 by 23 0.0435 24 divide 1 by divide by 24 0.0417 1 divided by 25 will get 0.0400. Multiplied the frequency column with the reciprocal of x. So 4 multiplied by 0.0500 will get 0.2000. 2 multiplied by 0.0476 we will get 0.0952. 7 multiplied by 0.054 we get 0.3178. 1 multiplied by 0.0435 will get 0.0435. 3 multiplied by 0.0417 will get 0.1251. 1 multiplied by 0.0400 will get 0.0400. So taking the sum of the column from 0.20 up to 0.040, we will get 0.8216. So harmonic mean n summation f divided by summation f into 1 over x. So summation frequency column sum is 18 divided by 0.8216. We will get 21.9084. Question: calculate the harmonic mean of the marks from the following table. Class from 0 to 7. So student is 19, frequency is 19, 7 to 14 is 25, 14 to 21 is 36, 21 to 28 is 72, 28 to 35 is 51, 35 to 42 is 43, 42 to 49 is 28. So the first column is known as the classes 0 to 7 up to 42 up to 49. Frequency column from 19 to 28. So taking the midpoint, midpoint column means the first class, the upper limit and lower limit added to each other and divide by 2, we will get the midpoint. So midpoint of the first class is 3.5. 7 plus 0 divided by 2, 3.5. 14 plus 7 is 21 divided by 2, we will get 10.5. similarly, we can find the midpoint of other classes: 17.5, 24.5, 31.5, 38.5, 45.5. and taking the reciprocal of the midpoint column of 1 over x, 1 by 3.5, 0.2857, 1 divided by 10.5, 0.0952, 1 divided by 17.5, we will get 0.0571, 1 divided by 24.5, we will get 0.0408, 1 divided by 31.5, we will get 0.0317, 1 divided by 38.5 will get 0.0259. So 1 divided by 45.5 will get 0.0219. So the 1 over x column is multiplied with frequency column. 19 multiplied by 0.2857 will 5.4283. 25 multiplied by 0.0952, we will get 2.3800. 36 multiplied by 0.0571 will get 2.0556. 72 multiplied by 0.0408, we will get 2.9376. 51 multiplied by 0.0317, you get 1.6167. 43 multiplied by 0.0259, 1.1137. So 28 multiplied by 0.0219, we will get 0.6132. So taking the column, sum of the column of the frequency is 274. Sum of the column of f by x will get 15.6951. So summation f divided by summation f by x. So harmonic mean 274 divided by 15.6951. We will get 17.4578. This is the required answer.